Good morning, 8th standard. I welcome you all for this today's session. Today you are going to see a new topic. So today's topic will be le verbe pronomino. So before going to that, let me ask few questions based on time. Okay, so shall we start? So last class we saw time, right? So for 12 o'clock in the afternoon, how do we call 12 o'clock in the afternoon in French? Any idea? So two difference I said. One is direct method and one is indirect method. In 12 o'clock in the noon is called as what? Okay. Hope you would have guessed it. So I'll tell the answers. Please cross check with your answer. Il e midi. Il e midi. Okay, so the next question is 12 o'clock in the midnight. That is the start of a new day. 12 o'clock in the midnight is called as what? 12 o'clock in the midnight is called as what? Il e minuit. Il e minuit. So now let us revise minutes once. Okay, all the minutes: cinq, dix, quinze, vingt, vingt-cinq, trente, trente-cinq, quarante, quarante-cinq, cinquante, cinquante-cinq, midi or minuit. Okay, so now next question. There are two timings which I explained. One is direct method and one is railway timing, right? Okay, so in railway timing, I will ask you one question. In case, if I say 14 hours, 14 hours in French, how will you say in railway timing? 14 hours. 14 hours minus 12 hours, that is equal to 12, 2. So it is 2 o'clock in the afternoon, right? It is 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So this 2 o'clock in the afternoon, it is the answer could be said in two methods. One is direct and one is railway timing. So in direct method, how you will say? I'll give you 5 seconds time and then I'll tell you the answers. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So hope you would have guessed the answer. Now I'll tell the answer. Il est deux heures. Il est deux heures. Il est deux heures de l'après-midi. In case if it is afternoon, de l'après-midi. In case it is just direct timing, before 12, we can say il est 12 heures. Il est 14 heures. Okay? So, railway timing, il est 14 heures means, that means 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Right? So, first method is 2 o'clock of the afternoon. That is direct method. Il est 2 heures. The l'après-midi. If not, we can directly say il est 14. That means it was 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So hope this revision is enough and we can enter into today's topic. So today's topic would be le verbe pronomino. So before getting into topic, just let us discuss on few things that we do for ourselves. For example, you get up in the morning. Okay, what do you do for yourself? The first and foremost thing, you get up. Imagine you are sleeping. Immediately you get up, you open your eyes. Okay. And you get up from your bed, you are sleeping, you open your eyes and you get up from your bed. Right? So, is anyone lifting you up every day or you get up on your own? You are getting up on your own, right? So, this is called an action which you do for yourself. It is called as reflexive verb. What verb is it? It is reflexive verb. Yes, exactly, it is a reflexive verb. So how does this reflective verb helps us to describe our day, to explain our day? A day is what? 24 hours is a day. So that's why we taught timing first and now we are stepping into this explanation of the day. La journée. In French it is called as la journée. La vie quotidienne. La vie quotidienne means the daily routine. So, Let us explain our daily routine. First, we will get up from the bed. We wash our face. We have a cup of coffee without brushing our teeth, right? Okay. So after that, we take bath and we dress up ourselves. We get ready for the day and immediately we will step into the kitchen. Our mom will be cooking something. We'll have the breakfast and then we will walk to our school or we'll come by bus and then we will do our daily routine, that is timetable. We will finish our timetable and then we get back to home. And evening time, we watch TV for some time and we play for ourselves and we enjoy ourselves and then we'll go back to the study area and we'll study there. After finishing all these things, we will go to bed, right? And we sleep and we make our bed and we sleep ourselves. This is a daily routine, okay? This daily routine in French is used by reflexive verb and this reflexive verb is called as le verbe pronominal. So this reflexive verb is called as what? Le verbe pronominal. So this is otherwise called as pronominal verbs. This pronominal verb is both same in English as well as in French. But what we do is we use English less and French more. Sir, what do you mean by English less and French more? In English, we will not say I get up myself. We will say I get up at 6 o'clock, right? But in French, we will say I get up myself at 6 o'clock. I brush up myself. I comb my hair myself. I bath myself. So this myself or oneself will keep on coming. Okay? So how do we do this? I brush up myself. How will I tell this, sir? That is what we are going to see today. Okay? So I'll tell you how we are going to do that. Le verbe pronominal. This is same as you do the ER conjugation. Normally ER conjugation, what you will do? In case if the verb is ending with ER, you will add E, ES, E, O, N, S, E, Z, E, N, T. Am I right? So these are the endings you will do. That you will do to the right side portion. Okay? So what is this SE? This SE denotes that it is a reflexive verb. This SE denotes that it is a reflexive verb. Reflexive verb is nothing but action we do to ourselves. For example, this is one verb, reflexive verb. Se lever, that means to wake up. Or we can say to wake up oneself. We are not going to wake up anyone. We are going to wake up ourselves, right? So that's it. Se lever, to wake up is the translation. Je me lève. Now, what does this me indicates? This me indicates myself. Te indicates yourself. Se indicates himself or herself. This no generally indicates we both, right? Here, the second no indicates ourself. We get up ourselves. And this who indicate group of people getting up themselves. That is, we can say you yourself got up. This is they themselves got up. Okay? So, this me, te, se, nu, vu, se. This is indicating the reflection of the verb. The action which is going to repeat for oneself. Okay? Now, the verb is nothing but just like an ER verb. The way ending with ER, so we are adding, we can take out the ER, we are adding E, ES, E, ONS, EZ, EN. Je me lève, but we cannot say je lève. Je lève means I wake. But that is not the right way of telling it. We have to say je me lève. I wake up myself. Tu te lèves. You wake up yourself. Il se lève. He or she wakes up himself or herself. Nous nous levons. You wake up yourself, sorry, we wake up ourselves. Who live in, that is you guys wake up on your own yourself. Il se lave, that is they wake up themselves. So this leve, when it is conjugated, it will have an accent only, there will not be any accent for nu and bu. That please don't forget. This is just one example of this pronominal verb. There are lot of pronominal verbs that we do for ourselves. In case if you see in the French passage, in this lesson, if you see this French passage, there are lot of verbs which denotes the pronominal verb. For example, first one is, in the first line itself, there are lot of pronominal verbs. Elle se lave, elle se lave, elle se lave. Lave is washing the face. Elle s'habille, getting dressed up. Elle prépare le petit déjeuner pour les enfants. Elle prend sa voiture. So there are pronominal verbs which helps them to tell the particular action. So this lesson is based off of a woman explaining her day by herself, right? The same way these verbs helps us to explain our day. Our day, 12 hours we live and the rest 12 hours we eat and we sleep, right? That 12 hours, whatever actions we say or we do, that is denoted by levare pronomino. So this is the base, levare pronomino. Please repeat, levare pronomino. And the example is se lever, se lever. I repeat, je me lève, je me lève, tu te lèves, il se lève, nous nous levons, vous vous levez, il se lève, elle se lève. So this is the one method to explain our day. Okay, like this, there are many pronominal verbs that is listed in page number 29, there are many pronominal verbs. So I think you can't see here, but so I will show this in the screening method. I will just read out once so that you will have an idea. S'appeler, the verb s'appeler is used to call someone. Je m'appelle Emmanuel. Tu t'appelles quoi? Tu t'appelles comment? So that is the verb which is used to explain the name of someone, calling someone. So second verb is amuser. Amuser. Amuser is a verb to explain the joy of yourself. Je s'amuse bien. So like this, there are number of verbs listed here. So what I am going to do is, I am going to explain these verbs in the screening method. So hope we can see the screening method now. I will explain these verbs, and based on this verb, we are going to do exercise number 2, 3 and 5. Okay, based on these exercises, you will have the online test. I believe exercise number 5 would be easy for your online test. So this one verb is enough. And this is a demo. Other verbs you can try to conjugate on your own. You just conjugate two verbs for today. That is enough. You pick out any two verbs from this list and you try to conjugate that particular verb before going to the test. Okay? So hope this information is easy for you. And please do the test well. And today's topic is levare pronomino. Please don't forget. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Okay, it's standard. Let's see the same levare pronomino. In pronominal or reflexive verbs, the action is done by the subject on itself. So that is what, as I explained on the board, these are the verbs, that is, action is used for the same individual. That particular is action is done for oneself. Okay, so we are just going to see an example. Se lever is the first verb. Je me lève. Tu te lèves. Il, elle, se lève. Nous, nous levons. Vous, vous levez. Il, elle, se lève. That is, this verb means to wake up. Okay? So, I wake up myself. So, morning, usually we will wake up ourselves, right? So any action that is used to do for ourselves, it is called as reflexive verb in English, and the same it is called as verbe pronomino in French. See the le verbe pronomino. So please repeat with me. Je me lève. Tu te lèves. Il, elle se lève. Nous, nous levons. Vous, vous levez. Il, elle se lève. Asseoir is to sit down. Je me assis. Tu t'assis. Il, elle s'assit. Nous, nous asseyons. Vous, vous asseyez. Il, elle assit. So this is one example and this is another example. In this verb, you might have a new doubt. That is, what does this me, te, se, nous, vous indicates? This me, te, se, nous, vous, se is used as a reflexive pronoun and precede the verb. Precede is before the verb. So that should be used only before the verb. Okay? So let us see other examples in verb pronomino. So you can just tell along with me. That will be easy for you. S'appeler. S'appeler. To be called. Je m'appelle. For the example, that is the example of je m'appelle. Tu t'appelles. Il s'appelle. Elle s'appelle. Nous, nous appelons. Vous, vous appelez. Il s'appelle, elle s'appelle. So these are the commonly used pronominal verbs. You might have a question, sir, why do we have to learn this? So these verbs are a daily routine verbs. For example, from the morning till evening, you do a lot of actions for yourself. And this lesson also is purely based on that. In case if you see this lady, Madame Loving, gets up herself and she does her work on her own, right? See, elle se lève, elle se lave, elle s'habille. So that is how she is starting her day. So she gets up herself, she washes her face and she dresses up herself and she is doing the daily routine. So to explain this daily routine like this, you need the help of this verb. So that is why we are going to learn this verb. So I'm starting with s'appeler, to be called. S'amuser, to enjoy oneself. So if you just note down well, if you enjoy, you're not enjoying for others. You enjoy for yourself. In case if you are going to a swimming pool, you just enjoy yourself. You do not enjoy for others. Asseoir. S'asseoir is to sit down. S'asseoir is to sit down. Se blesser. Se blesser is to hurt oneself. If you fall down, no one pushes you. You fall down and you get hurt for yourself. So that's why this oneself, then and there, they will indicate. Okay? To enjoy oneself. To sit down, no one is going to make you sit down. You will be sitting down on your own. Se brosser, to brush. Se brosser is to brush. Se coucher, to lie down, to go to bed. Se coucher is to lie down or to go to bed. Se dépêcher, to hurry. Se dépêcher is to hurry. Se déshabiller, to get undressed. In case if you are going for a shopping and coming back, you change your dress and you go to your home dress, right? Night dress, home dress. So you dress, undress on your own. S'habiller, to dress up oneself. Se laver, to wash oneself. That is, you can say washing, bathing. Se lever, to get up or to rise. Se promener, to go for a walk. Se réveiller, to wake up. Se tailler, to keep quiet, to be silent. Se raser, to shave. se baigner, to take a bath. So I'll repeat once again, you repeat with me, and then we'll go for the exercise. S'appeler, s'amuser, s'asseoir, se blesser, se broser, se coucher, se dépêcher, se déshabiller, s'habiller, se laver, se lever, se promener, se réveiller, se tailler, se raser, se baigner. So with the help of this, what we are going to do is, we are going to first conjugate. This one you should do on your own. Décrivez la journée de Philippe en regardant les images. So in case if you see here, see he is getting out of his bed. So for Madame Lavigne, what we said, elle se lève. So we can say Philippe se lève. Here he is bathing. We can say Philippe se baigne. Here he is taking breakfast. We can say Philippe prend le petit déjeuner. Here he is working. We can say Philippe fait son travail. Here he is going out. Here he is going to sleep. Elle, il se couche. Here he is going out. He is going out. Il sort. So like that, you should be able to décrivez la journée de Philippe en regardant les images. As you see, this is splitting of images. The same person is doing some activity. So if you see this list, based on this list, you will be able to solve this. So if you solve this, that is the learning. Okay. And mettez le dialogue dans le bon ordre. You can do this on your own. First, you should note, this also is based on the daily routine. So that's why I am telling, à quelle heure te se lève? So the answer, moi je me lève à 7 heures. Je me lève à 6 heures. Et toi? So you first note out how many questions are there. À quelle heure vas-tu au travail? So here's the question. So travail is here. Here's the answer. So like that you can find. First, count out how many questions are there, and then based on that questions, there will be some clues. Based on the clues, you can find the answer. So based on this daily routine, you have to do exercise number 2, exercise number 3, and exercise number 5. Exercise number 5 also, I will help you with first five, you have to do the second five, okay? La saison en Inde qui commence en juillet. Identifier en français. So, this thing we will wait, we will do it in some other day because this is regarding months and days. So, this is a separate exercise. Don't confuse this. So, you do exercise number 2, 3 and 5. That is based on today's topic. So the first one I will explain you, les filles dash s'amuser bien. So les filles, that is feminine plural. So first we have to go and see the tabular column, how they have conjugated. See, feminine plural, how they have conjugated. Se, lave, ent, right? So the same thing we have to do here. What we have to do is, les filles, se, s-e you have to write, and s'amuse. Amuse, A-M-U-S, this E-R will turn as E-N-T. Take a pencil and write down. Since I am going to give you first, last five as homework, I will not be able to show you the solutions. And today's online test will be based on this exercise. Okay, so I repeat the answer, S-E. For first one, S-E space A-M-U-S-E-N-T, amusant. Les filles s'amusent bien. So second answer, tous les matins, il se rase. So very simple. For il, you have to write the same, S-E, and rase, you have to take the R alone. So the answer is R-A-S-E. Il se rase. That is the second answer. Take it with a pencil. Third one, s'appeler verb. Je m'appelle, tu t'appelles, il s'appelle, elle s'appelle. So since already there is a vowel and the verb, just repeat the same. Elle s'appelle, S-A-P-P-L-E. So s'appeler verb alone, when the conjugation is there, double L will come. For nous and vous alone, single L will come, A-P-P-E-L-L-E. That is the answer for third one. Nous dash se brosser les cheveux. Nous brossons. So nous, so when there is a nous, we have to include another nous. Nous brossons, B-R-O, take out the E-R and write O-N-S. E-R should be taken out and you have to write O-N-S. Nous brossons les cheveux. That is the answer for the fourth one. Frédéric se dépêche comme il est en retard. Frédéric se dépêche. Frédéric is third person singular. So what we have to write? Frédéric se dépêche. Just we have to write the R. That is the answer. Dépêche with a E. So the answer is, take out the R. Else dépêche, the same spelling without R. That is the answer. Sixth one is tu s'habiller. Tu s'habiller. So the answer is tu se, tu te. So in the question, if you see tu, what is the conjugation for tu? See, tu te. What is written? Tu, for tu te, je me. So what you have to write is tu te. Tu te abi. A B H A B I double L E S. This is normal like ER verb. The ending is E E S E O N S E Z E N T. But the front part alone you should be alert. That is je me, tu te, il se, elle se, nous, vous, il se, elle se. So don't forget to write that. So I think this is clear for you. Since next four is in homework, I am not able to show you the solutions. Definitely you will do it well, I know. I'll give you a clue for seventh one, je me. And nous is here, so nous will repeat. Here Jacques and Marie, two people are there, one is male and one is female, so it will be ILS. And tenth one is mes enfants, that is plural, so it will be also come under ILS. So now what you do is, based on this, you finish 7, 8, 9, 10. So today's online test will be based on exercise number 5, so I request you to revise this exercise well and do exercise number 2 and 3 as a homework. 2 is here and 3 is here. So you take this as a homework and you do it. Okay. So today we have seen le verbe pronomino, commonly used pronominal verbs. You kindly revise this and memorize this, and you do your online test from exercise number 5 well today. So I thank you all today, and have a nice day.